In this video, Chris Stanley, podcast host and iPath founder, is going to show you the four most important things that need to be done in an auto inspection. Hint, these are the same things you want to do in a property inspection as well. And we're starting right now.
This is Adjuster TV.
Hey, it's Matt here with Adjuster TV. For the best tips and tools for getting on the first call list as a CAT property independent adjuster, subscribe now. Click on the bell notification and you'll be on your way. And thanks to Q from YouTube who says, thank you. Once again, a valuable video for someone like myself starting out. Thanks for watching, Q. Okay, inspecting autos and houses is a lot more than just deciding what's damaged and if it can be paid for or not. Chris Stanley is here to talk about the four things that need to happen on any auto inspection. And if you ask me, the fourth one is probably the most important one. Take it away, Chris.
All right, thanks, Matt. So like Matt mentioned, today I want to talk to you about what it really takes to complete an auto claim inspection. A lot of times we think one thing, but in reality it's completely different, and that goes with everything in life, much less in claims. Now, if you've ever done property inspections or any kind of inspection, there's not a whole lot of differences in auto versus property versus scene investigation, but there are some things that you need to consider when doing auto claims. So really, there's four big things that we do as auto damage appraisers or auto adjusters. The first thing we do once we have an appointment and we show up to the owner's house or the body shop where the car is at, is we're gonna have a conversation. And I call this the inspection conversation. This is where you talk with the owner, you talk with the body shop, and you have a conversation about what happened to this vehicle, what's related to this loss, and get the details of, according to them, what happened and where's the damages at. That way you're not going out and inspecting all the wrong things. Now there's a few things that are really important in that though I'll cover in a later video, but having a good conversation and actually listening during that conversation is pivotal to having an accurate estimate and good claim notes. So make sure you take the time to have an inspection conversation. The next step, once you've got the conversation out of the way and you know, according to everybody else, what's going on with this car, is you need to get photos. And now photos, just like in property or any other claim, is so important. If you can't document it, you can't write it. And that is huge in the auto world. So getting the accurate, expected, industry standard photos is something that for you to get paid, you have to do. If you fall short, you miss one of the required photos, then guess what? You're not gonna get paid. So it's really important to take the time and do the photos right. Now I have an exact order that I recommend that you do photos in just because I like it, because it's efficient and it makes sure I never miss a photo. But just understand, that's the second part of doing an auto claim, is getting those photos right, making sure you get not only the damages, but also all the required photos of the vehicle, the inside of the vehicle, the VIN, the odometer, all that stuff that we'll cover in detail later. Now you need to assess the damage, or do what I call a scope. You need to scope out the damage and take notes. You need to determine what's the major panel that's damaged, what needs to be R&I'd, what needs to be blended, what repair operations are really needed. Does this part need replaced or does it need repaired? And determining all of that while you're at the vehicle is super important, because writing off of photos, you've ever heard of adjusters complaining about photo apps and how bad estimates are done off of photos? Well, if you don't take good notes during your inspection, your estimate is gonna be lackluster, to say the least. So taking good notes at the vehicle and then taking any additional photos based on what you're seeing and what you want to document is important. So that third step of this auto claim inspection is the scope in your notes. All right, and then the fourth thing is you have to set expectations, right? This is huge, because during this inspection time, the owner or the body shop, they're either expecting the right thing or the wrong thing. And if you don't set the expectations or reset the expectations, you're gonna be letting people down. If you don't tell them it's gonna take you a day or two to compile your estimate and complete it and get it to the insurance company, then they expect that you're gonna be done and handing them a check in the next 5 minutes, right? So coming back to that owner and setting the right expectations is so important. It will save you so much heartache. Now this starts at the beginning of the claim, setting expectations, but at the end of the inspection, re-coming back, sitting down with that owner or shop or whoever it is you're having a conversation with and setting those expectations is the right way to conclude an inspection. So let's go over the four real quick in a summary. Number one, you gotta have the inspection conversation. This is that first conversation with the owner or body shop. What happened to the vehicle, right? What's the story behind this loss? Number two is getting all the photos to document the damages that of that story, to tell the story visually, not just from the owner's perspective, but from the damage perspective. The third step is then to go ahead and take good notes. Notes for you. No one's gonna see these notes, but you need to have the detailed notes for you to get back and write a good, fair, and accurate estimate. And lastly, you gotta go set the expectations. If you can do those four things, then you're gonna have a good auto inspection, even if your estimate sucks. That's the key, is even if your estimate is no good and you're a beginner, if you do those things, you're still properly executing on the auto claim. All right, that's the four steps to an auto inspection. Thanks, Matt. Send it back to you.
Question of the day. Do you like this new content about auto claims with Chris? Let us know in the comments below. And for much more information about handling auto claims, head on over to AdjusterTV.com. And if you got value from this video, you can help me create more videos just like this by hitting the round subscribe button. Wondering what to watch next? Check out these videos. And as always, thank you so much for watching and have a great storm. A painter who lived in Great Britain interrupted two girls with their knitting. He said with a sigh, "That park bench, well, I just painted it right where you're sitting."